The Atlas of Economic Complexity, the Harvard Growth Lab's free online tool that translates economic growth research into policy actions to expand global prosperity, is proud to introduce Country Profiles, a first-of-its-kind platform that revolutionizes how to think about economic strategy, policy, and investment opportunities for over 130 countries. Country Profiles invites users to take an interactive, step-by-step journey to analyze a country's economic dynamics and future growth prospects, including identifying what new industries are poised to take off. Country Profiles are powered by a robust, data-rich framework from a decade of economic complexity research and distilled into a curated profile of stunning data visualizations to guide policy and investment decisions. Let's dive in. We all know that countries do not grow equally. Our research at the Growth Lab finds that countries' growth is also not random, but follows a pattern in which countries incrementally expand the diversity and sophistication of their know-how. The more diverse the set of specialized know-how a country has, the more diverse the set of goods and services it can produce, of increasingly greater complexity. The intro outlines whether a country has grown and whether it has increased its economic complexity. Here we see the rapid growth in China shows a close association with the country's gains in economic complexity. Country Profiles allow you to explore these findings across four dimensions: economic structure, market dynamics, strategy space, and growth opportunities. Use the icons to skip ahead at any time. Let's start exploring. In order to understand what new growth opportunities there are, we begin by examining what a country knows how to produce via their exports. The layout of the Country Profiles presents a core visual explained by the left side narrative and highlighted indicators on top. China's export basket is highly diversified, no longer only producing garments in green, but now being led by electronics and machinery in blue. If you face any navigation problems at any point, you can click the question mark. Advance to the next page using your up and down arrows. This new visualization looks at market dynamics over time, whether exports have grown, and whether growth has been driven by complex exports or raw materials. China shows a promising pattern. Its fastest growth has come from high complexity sectors in electronics and industrial machinery. Country Profiles also study a key source of growth via structural transformation, as countries reallocate economic activity from low to high productivity sectors. The economic success stories in global growth have followed a similar pattern of structural transformation in moving from agriculture into garments, followed by electronics, and later machinery. Growth Lab research finds countries do not grow by producing more of the same, but by diversifying to add new products of increasing complexity. The visual shows all of the new products China has added over the last 15 years, earning a diversification grade of an A+ for China. If the key to growth is diversifying into more complex production, how do countries diversify? The answer is held in the product space, which uses real-world data to map over 800 products based on the probability that a country produces both products. The space shows that countries diversify into technologically related products that require similar know-how in production. So countries that produce t-shirts are more likely to produce women's suits as they require similar know-how in production. But that same country is unlikely to produce computer monitors, which require different know-how and are more distant in the product space. For policymakers interested in the strategic approach their country should take to foster growth, we consider two dimensions. Is your country well connected to many new opportunities? And is it complex enough for its income level to grow? Countries that are well connected to new opportunities and complex enough to grow may follow a light touch approach to expand on existing successes. Here we find China. Countries that are well connected but aren't complex enough may follow parsimonious industrial policy to resolve bottlenecks to support gains in complexity. Here we find Turkey. The most complex economies are not well connected to new opportunities because they have already populated the high-value segments of the product space and may follow technological frontier policy to create wholly new global products. Think Japan. Many developing countries face the dual challenge of lacking the complexity to grow and not being well connected to new opportunities, and may follow a strategic bets approach to make a few coordinated jumps into areas that are well connected to allow for continued future diversification. Here we find Ethiopia. Investors often ask, what are the promising new opportunities for a country? This research adds three concepts to consider. The distance of a product to existing know-how to be more nearby in the product space. The complexity of the product, as greater complexity tends to support higher wages. And the opportunity gain of a product, a key element for policymakers, as well-connected products open up opportunities for continued diversification. Country profiles allow you to select from three portfolios to analyze new products. The visualization highlights the selected products for each portfolio, while the next page details further info on the selected products. Finally, we've arrived at one of the most powerful aspects of country profiles, a spreadsheet. Not just any spreadsheet, this is a high-powered spreadsheet listing the new industries with the highest value based on the selected portfolio. For Vietnam, this potential is in electronics and industrial machinery. For Ethiopia, a low-hanging fruit portfolio features, well, prepared fruits and vegetables and apparel sectors. The table lists additional information on the global market size and growth of each product. The table can be resorted according to any column. By clicking on a product, you can explore the full market dynamics of that product from destination markets to competing exporters. The products in this table are not an end result, but an entry point for further study. Ultimately, policymakers should be careful not to narrowly engage in picking winners, but should study the true feasibility of these industries and address what constraints may prevent their takeoff. Growth in the future is far from guaranteed, however, but country profiles offer insights into the policy approach and promising sectors to increase an economy's complexity and achieve more rapid growth. But one question remains. What country will you explore next?